Hello, welcome to another edition of Comrie's Corner. I'm honored to be Leroy Comrie, State Senator for the 14th District of Queens. We're here again to show you some of the ins and outs of policy in the state budget and to give our viewers an inside look on the world of government in New York State. I'm proud to welcome this week's guest, Madelyn Thorne, Executive Director of Habitat for Humanity in Schenectady County. Welcome, Madelyn. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you. Can you describe Habitat for Humanity for those folks that do not know what Habitat stands for? And what do you do as the Executive Director?
Well, first off, with Habitat for Humanity, the very simple goal of Habitat for Humanity is to help as many people as we can, first-time homebuyers, find their way into the self-determination and self-respect that homeownership brings to people. So we try to create the opportunities for safe, affordable housing for as many people as we can afford to do. And Habitat for Humanity was founded in 1977.
77.
With that very simple idea, everyone deserves safe, affordable housing. And that's how it all started.
Oh, great. And where was Habitat founded? In New York? Or
No. In America's Georgia.
In America's Georgia,
right. In America's Georgia.
Right. President Carter had a lot to do with this.
Yes, he did. Yes. Habitat was going along and doing very well. But then, of course, once our President Carter joined forces with Habitat for Humanity, well, things just grew from there at a wonderful exponential rate.
Okay. Yeah. And how long has Habitat been in Schenectady County?
We have been in Schenectady County for 24 years.
Okay.
And to date, we have completed 50 houses. Mm. So that's 50 first-time home buyers.
Right.
And it's been a wonderfully successful program. So we're very pleased to be there.
Well, I'm familiar with Habitat in New York City. We have
Good.
Some Habitat homes in our district that people have put in sweat equity in.
Oh, your affiliates down in New York City, Queens and so on, you guys are fierce. You're game changers down there.
Do you have a sweat equity program here for the home buyers as well?
Yes, we do. Yes, and the whole purpose of sweat equity, Senator, is to show that it is a partnership. I want to be clear that when people attain home ownership through the Habitat for Humanity program, they are purchasing that house and they are working towards that house. They're going to pay mortgage. They're going to pay taxes. They're going to pay their insurances. It is not an entitlement program, and sweat equity is part of that partnership.
Right.
Yeah.
And how many hours do they put in into the program?
Well, every affiliate gets to define its own requirement for sweat equity. And that is because every affiliate needs to meet the requirements of its particular community.
Okay.
So in our case, we will take up to, it might be up to 300 sweat equity hours. Mm. Some affiliates find 200 hours more appropriate. Again, it's an individual approach towards that community's need.
Right. And how can a person that's interested in becoming a Habitat owner start the process? What is the process for them to get involved?
Well, the very simple thing is we have what's called a pre-application process because, Senator, we are asking our families to meet certain income guidelines,
mm-hmm.
low to moderate incomes as defined by HUD,
right.
And also first-time homebuyers, which according to HUD standards means you haven't had, not only you're a first-time homebuyer, but a home hasn't been in your name for 3 years. So some people who might have had a financial crisis 7 or 10 years ago, they have a second chance to come into home ownership.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah, it's great. It's really well thought out.
Those people that got mortgage fraud or ran into a family life-changing situation.
It happens, right?
Right. Oh, that's great. And you said that you've done 50 homes already in the 24 years. And how many homes do you have in the pipeline right now?
Right now we have numbers 51, 52, and we've got 53 and 54 planned out. So we're always looking ahead.
Right.
We're always doing constant outreach for families to bring them into the program, as are most affiliates, because one of the challenges we find, Senator, and I think you would agree this would be your experience too, is people often don't have the confidence. They don't know that they can achieve home ownership.
Right.
They don't know that this path is open to them. So let's keep educating people, and with the support of Sunny May and important programs like that you bring to us,
right. That's
really an important building block for us.
Okay.
Thank you for everything you've done.
Oh, I'm happy. Has this budget been helpful to you? Our past budget the budget that we just passed in the New York State Senate?
The New York State Senate budget is most helpful. It's the federal budget that has me a little worried right now, as you can understand. I mean, the HUD funding was decimated. We are hoping that our representatives on a federal level will go to bat for us. And with the great representatives we have in New York State, you know, Senators Gillibrand, Schumer, in our district, Congressman Paul Tonko, I have every faith that they are fighting hard for us, and ultimately, we're going to win.
Oh, I hope so. You know, it's a difficult time trying to figure out what is going on in Washington and who's figuring out what. And it seems like they cannot get on first base with their own opinion. And being in leadership for the Republicans is a lot different than throwing stones. So,
yeah, you know, it's
hopefully their communities and their constituents will let them know that Habitat is a program that should be maintained and kept. And it's a program that also teaches people the rubrics of you know, how to drive a nail, how to do construction, how to do financing.
That's correct.
You know, it's a pretty intensive program. Can you describe how your financing component for the homeowners and how you help them achieve the opportunity to get a mortgage?
Certainly, we depend on a lot of private donations. That's, of course, very important to us. Good community-minded people that want to help their own community, they help fund us.
Okay.
But we also have access to federal grant programs that come to us through New York State, as well as the Sunny May program now helps a lot of our families be able to afford that. At this point, we're talking a 30-year, 2% fixed mortgage. That's integral to our program. So I'm asking you for your support for that and continued support.
Well, we hope to be able to do something.
Much like a house is a lot of building blocks, well, the financing for a Habitat home is a lot of building blocks that all it's a serious foundation that we have to put down.
Great. And how do individuals that want to volunteer to you know, work on a Habitat home, how do they reach out?
Well, every affiliate will have a website, and on those websites will be a tab to fill out an application to volunteer. And that is, again, you're asking such great questions. That's again, an integral part is the community coming together as volunteers to help a family find their way to home ownership. So the community really binds with the family, and it's a not only are our volunteers teaching brand new homeowners, as you have just pointed out, the skills of repairing a home or putting up a wall or painting the wall correctly or all of that. So it's good community-minded volunteers that come on site. But I do want to emphasize, by the way, volunteers don't need to come with a skill set. You come onto a Habitat site, we're going to show you what to do. Don't even worry about not knowing how to paint or hang drywall or whatever. We're going to have you doing it.
Okay. By the time you leave, you'll be able to have a real working knowledge of
sure.
it. And even more importantly, you'll be able to look at a contractor and know if he's doing the right job or
there you go.
Job.
Yes. Yeah.
Or that's even more important for a lot of people. So that's great. What do you think is a challenge for Habitat at this point in time, other than the uncertainties of a federal budget?
Well, the challenges are truly getting young families to understand, particularly when you've had generational renters, they have blocked, almost mentally blocked out the possibility of home ownership. So we have to constantly educate. Please come to us, you know, please try the program. Work with us, we will work with you. So that's a lot of it, is looking, just getting people to understand, have faith in that home ownership possibility for them and their families, and all the benefits that come with that.
Mm-hmm.
And as always with any not-for-profit, home ownership, or I'm sorry, fundraising is just a challenge now.
Mm-hmm.
There's certainly with a lot of the wealth feeding up to the 1%, that leaves us with having to do a whole lot less, or a whole lot more with a whole lot less.
Right.
It's the way to put that.
Right. Do you get local contractors that are interested in helping out Habitat?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
And that's going to be very individual to the relationship the affiliate has with particular contractors. But as I'm sitting here telling you, we have a wonderful volunteer who does our electrical work, never sends us an invoice. And, I mean,
That's a big number.
That's a big. Yeah. And Habitat houses and condos and et cetera are built with volunteers, but as you well know, there's certain criteria where you have to have that licensure.
License, right.
You know, electrician, plumber, all of those. So
to
when
meet
we can
the
get
building codes. And,
correct.
And you can't get around building codes even if you're Habitat.
No, so. And you shouldn't get around building. They're there for a reason.
Right.
Right.
Right. Okay, well, that's excellent. So you mentioned condos. You do condos as well?
Some affiliates, because that is what works with... Now, we don't do condos in Schenectady because Schenectady is very much of an individual home place. We don't even have a lot of row homes or townhouses.
Right.
Very much single-unit houses.
Okay.
But there are some areas within our country where condos are what makes sense. So again, Habitat for Humanities are designing programs that work within
the local community.
The local community.
Okay.
Does it make sense to build a ranch-style house or a two-story house or an apartment building? Mm. What makes sense?
Okay. All right. Great. And while you're looking at, how do you identify a home? You just said what makes sense to build a ranch or a two-family or mm-hmm. one-family. How do you identify the properties? Are they brought to you? Or?
Well, I'll tell you, there's another great program that we're lucky to have in New York State, and that's come out of the Democratic leadership, is the land bank.
Okay.
That has been so important to any Habitat because it has made land accessible to us.
Right.
So that's a great, and please support the land bank.
I have to. It hasn't come up specifically since I've been in office in 2014, but I'm sure it's something that, you know, when we have the opportunity, I'll definitely support. So
please, because that has made acquiring land much more affordable, or if at no cost, because we're going to bring that piece of property back to a tax-paying piece of property. So that's, again, land bank is one of those. It just bridged a big gap for us.
Right. Well, I haven't asked you anything about yourself, Madelyn. How did you come to want to be director of Habitat, and what did you do before?
Well, for a lot of years, I was a salesperson, and I'm very comfortable with people, and I have a good time, and I have that gives you a sense of business and how business works.
Mm.
And then I was on the board of Habitat for Humanity because it is something that I truly, truly believe in.
Okay.
I was a single mother with a child to take care of, and I bought my first house, and I understand how challenging it can be. It's been many, many years, of course, now. So when I had the opportunity to help other people find their way to that real determination of the American dream,
Right. Well,
wasn't it my pleasure to be able to do so?
Oh, okay. All right. Great. And you said you're in Schenectady County. Is there an Albany County or Rensselaer County?
Yeah. Oh, well, Rensselaer County and Albany County merged together. So
Okay. That's
called the Capital District Habitat. But we also have habitats in Montgomery County. We have one that's just starting up and really getting its wheels under it in South Glens Falls. So I want to say about 1,500 affiliates across the United States.
Mm.
And then as well, it's an international effort. In third world countries with not only housing but water systems and irrigation systems and so on.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
It's all about helping people live with dignity.
Great. Well, I want to thank you. But can you just tell me one more thing? I understand that next week will mark the 10th anniversary of the National Women Build Week.
Yes,
sir. Can you explain that to the audience as well?
Well, Women Build is an effort by Habitat for Humanity to include women in this process.
Okay.
So during Women Build Week, most of the construction sites across the United States are going to be majority women volunteers, learning those skills, working together. It's really not about excluding males. Let me say, it's about including women in this process, giving them the confidence that, yeah, you can handle a power drill. Sure, you can go up that ladder.
Mm-hmm.
You carry that 5-gallon pail. And it helps women understand they are part of the solution for our country. They are part of this unity that we have.
Right.
A lot of our homeowners are single moms. So isn't this great that women are helping women?
Oh, okay, great.
Very positive.
Well, thank you. We've run out of time already again, Madelyn, but I want to thank you for being here. I'm stopping by Comrie's Corner to share what you do with Habitat for Humanity. And I really want to thank you, Madelyn Thorne, for being with us. And I hope that we can talk again. And I just wanted to give the audience an opportunity to understand that Habitat for Humanity is a program that we should all either volunteer with or support. Again, this is Leroy Comrie, and this is Comrie's Corner. Thank you for watching, and please stay in contact with my office about other informational things that you may be interested in. And also, if you need to reach out to our office, please do not hesitate to be in contact with us. Thank you for watching Comrie's Corner. My number is 718-765-6359. Remember, that's a new number, 718-765-6359. Thank you.